physics tells us that, at a fundamental level, the world behaves less like hard billiard balls and more like ripples in a pond. This wave nature of reality means that what we imagine as distinct particles of matter are actually quite fuzzy. In quantum physics, this characteristic of reality is captured in the Heisenberg uncertainty principle.
The Heisenberg uncertainty principle plays a big role in these very, very, very small scales, so at the scale of atoms. It's a principle that states that you cannot know both the position and the momentum of a particle to arbitrary accuracy both at the same time. But the particle is not the only thing that can have a wave nature. Water waves, for example, radio waves, any kind of waves that we see in our world can actually have a similar uncertainty relation.
Consider sound waves. A typical tune is composed of many overlapping frequencies. But if we play a specific note, like middle C, its frequency falls within a narrow band. The width of this band is a measure of the uncertainty about its precise frequency. The shorter the duration of a note, the wider its bandwidth, and greater the uncertainty in its frequency. The longer the duration of the note, the narrower its bandwidth, and the more precise its frequency.
If you take a signal which is, say, this thick, you know, this, the width is this, and the bandwidth is this, these two widths, if you multiply them, is a constant. So if you narrow this, this will increase. If you make this fatter, this will decrease. And that the mathematics is identical to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle.
Heisenberg determines similar relationships for particles at the quantum level. For instance, the uncertainty in position, written as delta x, multiplied by the uncertainty in momentum, written as delta p, is always greater than or equal to a constant, written as h over 4 pi. We can see the Heisenberg uncertainty principle at play in the diffraction of light.
So what we can do is we can have a little slit and we can point a laser through the little slit and we can slowly make the size of the slit smaller and smaller and smaller. In the beginning, there will be a pattern on the wall, which is basically a blob of light or a point of light coming from the laser. But after a certain time, when we make it even tinier, then actually what we see is that this blob of light kind of diffracts out into a large pattern on the wall. So this can be explained by the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. When we are making the size of the slit smaller, we're trying to make sure that we are sending the beam of light through a very accurate position size. This, in turn, translates into saying that there will be an uncertainty in measuring the momentum of the light packet. So this uncertainty manifests itself as an angular uncertainty, which falls on the wall and produces this diffraction pattern.
Heisenberg extended the uncertainties that are evident in all waves to the realm of quantum particles.
We cannot determine where an electron is at a particular point in space-time, and then also determine what its energy or what its momentum is at the same particular space-time point. And this is very important because it tells us about the stability of matter. So when we start from classical electrodynamics, the problem was that there's the nucleus at the center and the electron which is accelerating around the nucleus at the center. And if it continues on this acceleration, then it should go closer and closer and closer to the nucleus and fall into the nucleus. But that does not happen because we know that most matter is stable and the universe is not disintegrating. Here's when the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle kicks in, and it says that if we know that the electron is going closer and closer and closer to the nucleus, then we know its position to great accuracy. And if we know its position to great accuracy, that means the uncertainty in its momentum is increasing and increasing and increasing the more and more closer it comes to the center of the nucleus. And this is not possible because the electron can only have so much energy as we can calculate from electrodynamics. And because this is not possible, we know that there is an inherent uncertainty in where the position of the electron is.
No, if quantum mechanics is correct, there is no way of measuring its position or momentum accurately simultaneously. It has nothing to do with the limitations of our instruments. It's a fuzziness built into nature.
The Heisenberg uncertainty principle reflects the fundamental nature of reality, and it is that uncertain nature that allows for atoms, chemistry, and all the solid stuff of our everyday world.
It does give us a new insight into reality. It tells us that in reality things are fuzzy, But at the same time, it also opens up a door to many different ways of viewing that reality. It's an extremely rich sort of doorway into what reality is.